Now welcome Professor Grover for the next address. Professor Grover, a Padma Shri conferred by Government of India, is currently the Vice Chancellor of Homi Bhabha National Institute. It's a deemed university dedicated to research and development in the frontier areas of nuclear science and technology. Professor Grover.
Good morning, Dr. Chidambaram, Dr. Sinha, Dr. Shekhar Basu, Shri K.C. Purohit, Dr. Vijayan, Dr. Nayak, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to all present for this prestigious conference, which, as Dr. Vijayan mentioned, is the fifth in the series of these conferences. I think Dr. Vijayan alluded to climate change. Let us talk more about it. Towards the end of 18th century, to be precise, in 1798, Thomas Malthus observed how growing global population has not and will not allow any improvement in living standards. However, scientific discoveries and resulting industrial revolution proved him wrong. Malthus was one of the earliest in a long line of distinguished prognosticators who predicted doom but turned out to be wrong. There have been several similar predictions, and to cite just one more, one can recall the report, The Limits of Growth, published in 1972 by the Club of Rome. So far, scientific developments have not allowed these predictions to come true, and standards of living have been continuously rising. However, one prediction being made now by scientists themselves is worrisome and needs to be taken seriously. And this is the prediction about climate change due to rising concentrations of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. Climate change seems to be real and calls for development and deployment of carbon neutral technologies to meet global energy needs. In the quest for carbon neutral technologies, nuclear energy can play a dominant role, and all of us who work in the area of nuclear energy have to do their bit towards realizing this goal. That would involve deploying proven technologies, working on new technology options to improve safety, reliability, and economics, locating more fuel resources, and developing technologies to get the maximum out of nuclear fuel resources available to us. The importance of thorium energy conference lies in exploring ways to get maximum energy out of thorium resources. At this stage, I would like to recall climate change commitments communicated by India earlier this month in the form of what is known as intended nationally determined contribution in response to Conference of Parties decision for the period 2021 to 2030. These include 8 elements, and 2 of the elements are worth recalling here. One is reducing emissions intensity of GDP by 33% to 35% by 2030 from 2005 level, and the other is achieving about 40% cumulative installed capacity from non-fossil-based energy sources by 2030. In the detailed part of the report dealing with promotion of clean energy, clean sources identified include wind, solar, biomass, hydro, nuclear, and clean coal. Also included in this category is smart grid mission. India has always supported nuclear energy as a clean source and as an essential element of its electricity mix, and its inclusion in the national response to Conference of Parties to UNFCCC further reinforces its commitment for nuclear energy. This requires an equally strong commitment from nuclear scientists to work for technologies that ensure safety and economic competitiveness. Use of uranium in once-through cycle for energy generation is well established, and necessary data have been generated over the years. In case of thorium, this is a work in progress and needs to be expedited. All technology options have to be explored. It could be molten salt reactors, fission fusion hybrids, accelerator driven system, and of course conventional thermal or fast reactors. One has to choose the option that is found safe as well as economical. The conference is covering all topics, as one can see from the program, and I compliment the organizers, particularly Dr. Vijayan, Dr. Nayak, in putting a very good program together, and I'm sure the conference will further spur R&D aimed at thorium utilization. In the end, my welcome to all of you once again. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Grover. I'm sure the audience has enjoyed his address and his take on the role of nuclear energy to have a clean climate, atmosphere.